to it like a song.
Yeah.
Because we come and believe you.
Yeah.
I don't know, it's not kicking in yet. Probably when I get there and see the way it's gonna get the nerves.
So sick.
I come here every day. Oh, has to be over 20 foot though.
Oh shit.
Conquer your fears. That's probably the best advice. They're going to be scared and, you know, Waimea's renowned as a pretty gnarly place. So they're going to be, you know, the heart's going to be pumping. But I think when they get out there, they'll be fine. And it's pretty mellow today. So I think they'll be right.
Yeah, how not to die.
Waimea's actually a really special place. And this break has a lot of mana to it, which is a lot of spirit. Be with this valley here. The winds tend to go offshore right in this area all the time. And very special place, you know, the river mouth lets out there. And I know back in the day they had the villages and stuff that would live inside the valleys. And this is a very special place, you know, it's a kind of a life-giving area. It was very abundant in food and resources, and to this day it harnesses some of the biggest surf that's rideable in the world.
Don't stand too close to me if you're left alone with me.
A lot of adrenaline, and then, like, I wasn't nervous standing on the beach, but once I got in the water, I'm like, okay, crap, I better not do something wrong and get myself hurt out here.
Yeah, that was really heavy.
I was just panicking so hard.
Like a different sport than the surfing the small wave. It's a different feeling too, so it's so good.
It was pretty scary.
Yeah, that was my first time at Waimea, and it was kind of, I was a little bit nervous before that, and then like go out and I don't know, I got a few like good, all right ones, like maybe five or something, and then last wave like almost died, but yeah, it was all right.
I was coming back out and then this massive set came, like the biggest one, and then I bailed and it broke right in front of me and I got hauled down for so long. And then I came up, didn't get a breath, and then the second one smashed on my head, and then, just wait for this, I was like down at the bottom, and I got a sea urchin stuck in my hair, that's how far down I was. And then I like passed out, and then I like floated back up to the top, and then I was just like lying there, and then like, I don't know, regained consciousness. And then Sasha came over and he was like, "You okay?" And I was like, "Yeah, I think so." And I was like really dizzy and stuff, and then, yeah. That was my story. And then I had to get the sea urchin out of my hair.
Yeah, I was scared. It sounds bad, but I kind of gave up. I was like, oh well, if I die now, it doesn't really matter. It didn't put me off surfing at all, or surfing bigger waves. Just made me maybe a little bit more experienced if that situation ever came again. Some heat has gotta catch on fire. Put it out.
was really scared. I was super nervous. But I was kind of watching from the channel for like quite a bit. And I was like, oh, should I catch a couple waves? And I was like, yeah, of course, I gotta get it. I'm out Waimea, I've gotta do it.
That was cool because everyone talks about Waimea and everyone like knows it as a big wave spot, and so paddling out and just kind of experiencing what it's like to be out there. I was so excited. That was cool, I loved that. Yeah.
I have never surfed Waimea, I've never surfed a wave like this or a big wave.